Yeah, I thought you were like,
Bonnie,
good to see you again.
When's the last time I saw you?
We saw you at the Much Music Awards. Remember you came to Toronto?
Right.
It was June? June-ish?
That was
a couple months ago.
Beating?
June 22.
Something like that.
I like that's okay. Yeah,
June
so 22,
weird. And now we're back with Mr. Taylor. So you know, it's amazing because I interviewed you for Sharkboy, and I'm thinking,
oh my.
From Sharkboy to Wolfboy.
Yeah.
Well, seriously, like, have you thought about this amazing transition, moving out of the water and getting fur?
It is quite a transition. It's exciting.
You work your ass off for this film, excuse my language, but seriously, you did such a good job in this.
Oh, thank you.
Really, how was it finding your inner wolf?
It was very serious, and I went to a dark place to find it. No, it was. I kind of left that to the CGI people. My job was to just jump in the air and hang there and let them convert me into this dark, scary wolf.
Yeah, but pretty intense, Taylor. I mean, the work that you put into this, it really shows, especially the physical stuff. Was that,
right.
You know, I mean, I know you have that martial arts background, but was that, you know, hard for you, a big challenge?
Yeah, absolutely. It required a lot of work, but I was extremely motivated, and I kept my eye on the prize, and the hardest thing was actually the eating.
Yeah.
Getting into the gym was fine because I was motivated, but the eating every 2 hours, every single day, was difficult.
Yeah, amazing. And then you still have to keep it up, right?
Like, yes, yeah. And it's hard when you're filming. Like, when we're filming Eclipse, we were working 16-hour days, so it's like, when do you find time to get into the gym? When do you eat during the day? It's quite challenging.
Yeah, now, what was it a happy day for you on set when you got to take out the wig, get rid of it?
We actually picture-wrapped the wig. Like, when a cast member gets picture-wrapped, it's a huge thing. Everybody gives a standing ovation. Woohoo! Picture-wrap on Taylor. We actually had a picture-wrap on the wig, and that was one of the best days of my life.
I can imagine. And why does it work so well between you and Kristen?
Why? I don't know, but thank goodness it does. Kristen and I, really weird to say, I mean, we have a relationship like Jacob and Dulles, and it helps so much. We're so open with each other and honest, and we can just talk about things. It's great. Kristen's an amazing person.
And I understand there's some grape-throwing contests going on set.
Did she tell you this? No way. Yeah, she...
Your skills are quite good, I understand.
I'm decent at catching, but she is quite amazing at throwing. She has an arm, but her accuracy is phenomenal.
I'll have to see that sometime. When you come back to Toronto, maybe you'll throw some grapes.
Yes,
I could throw some at you. We'll see what happens.
We could give it a shot, but I might feel lost without Kristen throwing the grape.
Yeah, you have your partner. It works. You know what? This could be an Olympic sport, maybe.
I could. Yeah. Professional grape catching.
The two of you could, yeah. We could think about that.
We'll think about it, definitely.
Now, of course, with Eclipse, I think you just recently finished shooting it, but we see more of the triangle between
yes.
you and Robert. You know, how is that dynamic? How did that all work, and, you know, how did it evolve? Because you guys know each other now so well.
Right. It was a lot of fun. It was. Eclipse was my favorite book. So actually to bring that to life was amazing. It has my favorite scene of the entire series, which is the tent scene. And it's where Bella is shivering to death, and Edward lets me sleep in the same sleeping bag as her to keep her alive, basically.
Yeah.
And it's a really funny scene. I find the movie's very dark, especially with our director, David Slade, but it's funny as well.
Very quickly, I just have to know how you're coping with all the fans and the attention. How are you handling it?
It's great. I mean, I've had a blast during this whole experience, and that fan support is amazing. We honestly have the best fans in the world.
Well, Team Jacob rocks.